Welcome to another edition of JavaScript View. This morning I want to take the same page we looked at with empty and do something very similar using remove. So we've used a same setup, div1, div2, div3, and put a child element in div3. And we have our function that is, instead of calling empty, is calling remove. Now this is going to look an awful lot like the same behavior. If you come over here, we'll notice that we have our divs down here. But if we hit remove, notice what happens. Instead of emptying out the child elements, it actually physically removes the entire page element that we selected. So we selected div3, calling removes that page element entirely. Doesn't just empty out the child elements, gets rid of it completely. So the two end up looking in this example like they're doing the same thing, but they have slightly different behavior, and depending on what you're trying to do, you may want to use one or the other. It also turns out that you can add an additional optional argument to remove with an additional selector to filter what you're removing. So you can decide to remove specific things. Now you could obviously do that in this selector here, but you can also filter it a little more finely down here. I'm not going through that, but that's really just for completion to mention that you can do that. So, that's about it for today. Until next time, have fun with JavaScript.